go from this to this. Hello and welcome. I'm reviewing Telemetry Extractor and Overlay today, and I'm using that for my Insta 360 One X2. So here we go. This is the product I'm looking at today. For the purposes of this review, I've been provided with the software, but my thoughts and opinions are my own, and I'm not being paid for this review. So I've opened up Telemetry Overlay, and the first thing I need to do is I need to import my video file from my Insta 360 One X2. And I've simply plugged it in, and all I do is I drag it across. And it optimizes the file, and then it loads the telemetry data. It can take some time, so I'm going to come back when that's done. So now we've imported the footage, and it sort of squashes it down and puts it in this square format, which I've got to say I don't really like. If I go to project, then I can specify the resolution. So they're square orientations, which doesn't always fit with the project you're doing, and it goes to 2880 native. Now you might find that that's just maybe a bit too big, so you might want to drop it down to something like 1440 by 1440. You can change the frame rate. I'm going to keep it as native. We can change the duration and the orientation. There's lots and lots of things we can change, which is really good. We can even change the font and the monospace and other things and all the colors. We can change the in and out points. But I'm going to go to gauges now, because what we can do is we can add gauges and we can take them away. So we can click on them and we can reorientate them. And up here, we can change their size. So I'm walking up a hill, so I'm really not going to be going that fast. So speedometer isn't particularly important to me. However, if I were riding a bike or doing skiing, then speedometer may be important for me. Probably the most important one is going to be this sort of elevation or altitude one. So I'm going to make that a little bigger. And this one here is going to be quite important, which is the GPS path. So I'm going to make that bigger. The distance traveled, I think that's quite important, so I'm going to make that bigger. I think it's important to say that the first one I showed you had everything in. So I'm going to get rid of that, and we click on the trash icon to get rid of it. I'm going to get rid of this one because I just want to really scale it down to the ones I need. I don't want to show how slow I'm going, so I'm going to get rid of this one as well. So I'm going to put this in the middle as well. So yeah, that's really good. I'm just going to make these really as big as I can. I'm in the edit gauge panel at the moment, and we can change things, like we can change the labels, the path, the shape, the units even. I'm not going to worry about these sort of things. They're there for an illustration, so I'm not worried that it's in miles and I like kilometers. I'm not worried it's in feet and I like meters. But if I did want to change it, then I could go here and I could change the unit to meters, and it changed it to meters, so I'm going to keep that. Now the other thing that's unfortunate, I'm using a 360 camera, so I'm not particularly happy with that, and I wouldn't want to show this footage like that. So what I'm going to do is, when I go to export, I can obviously change the format that it comes out in, how it's encoded, the quality, the render speed, etc. And I can include the audio, which I'm not going to do. I'm going to turn that off, but I'm going to turn chroma key on, because all I'm interested in is these bits. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to export it, and then I'm going to put it over the video, and we're going to talk about that in a moment. So you can see it's starting to prepare the MP4 output. And I will say I timed how long it took to import the video, and we're looking at between 3 to 4 minutes for a 4 minute 5.7K Insta360 video clip. So the rendering took about 22 minutes for a 5 minute clip. I'm happy with that, that's fine. I've got to say, I do like this software. Some of the downsides for the software are that you get your overlay in a square format. So I've got around that by, I've just duplicated the overlay and I've cropped to each statistic and I've just put it on my screen in a more pleasing fashion in a 16:9 ratio. I prefer that. I could have left it all together in a square format, but I didn't want to do that. I think it looks better like this. So let's talk about this software. Well, I really like the software. I think it's really good. I have an Insta360 One X2, and that records GPS data when you're using it with your phone, a smartwatch, or the remote. And with that, I can do a very similar thing within the Insta360 One X2 app, but it's not as good. It's a little bit more basic. With this software, I get much more control, and I can use it with other devices. I could use it with GoPros, Garmin Vibes, I could use it with my drone. There's lots more possibilities. It's much more polished. It doesn't work as quickly as with the Insta360 One X2 app, but you know what? That's okay. When you want a polished look, you're going to take a little bit more time. Like I said, rendering took about 22 minutes for a 5-minute clip. Obviously, that depends on the PC or the Mac you're using. Thank you so much and goodbye.